We did it, folks. We made it through to March. Somehow, making it through the slog that is January, seeing some relatively neat stuff in February, we're in the clear now. Awards season is over, the year-end dumping of odds and ends has completed, and now we can look forward to some fresh and fun new horror as we rapidly approach the summertime. It's not to say that the year has been completely devoid of quality horror flicks, though, far from it. It's just that the beginning of the calendar year tends to be slow in the cinemasphere. Fret not, there were some good flicks to grace the screens big and small. Let's see if you agree with my evaluation of the movies thus far. Hello, horror heads, and welcome back to the Scariest channel on YouTube, Top 5 Scary Videos. I'm your horror host, Keegan Hughes, and today we are counting down the top 5 best horror movies of 2020 so far. Keep in mind that I am actively avoiding flicks that I've already mentioned on my previous 2020 prediction lists for the sake of variety, and also because I was wrong about a lot of them. Take that as you will. Before we get started, make sure to give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe for more spooky, scary celluloid. Wicked. Let's begin. Coming in at number 5, we have Bliss. This flick is a psychedelic trip, man. It's all about an artist who decides that hallucinogens are the fast track to artistic success. Of course, our sweet, surly Desi rapidly spirals into the deep, dark depths of madness. To say that Bliss is visceral would be an understatement. You definitely feel like you're also on whatever the hell Desi is snorting. It'll leave you reeling, maybe even exhausted. A lot of folks are comparing it to Climax or Mandy, and for good reason. This flick elicits a lot of the same feelings you get when watching those two wild rides. Director Joe Bigo selected to shoot on 16mm, which is always welcome in my books. This choice gives the movie a very lively feel at the beginning and foregrounds the insane tonal shift later on as well. Once Desi inhales the bonkers powder, everything changes. The color palette becomes eye-scorchingly red and purple, and the cutting becomes frenzied and jumpy. It's loud, abrasive, and wild. Also, there are blood orgies and cannibalistic mayhem, all while Desi makes increasingly more inspired art. It's hard to pull a clear message from the flick, but not everything needs to be so black and white, and this flick is definitely not in grayscale. Give it a go and get taken for a ride. Swimming in at number 4, we have Underwater. It's Alien, but underwater. What else could you ask for? Anyone with a fear of drowning will find this terrifying. Folks who don't like lakes and oceans because of hidden creatures beneath their feet will shudder in despair as well. Now, like I said before, this is a flick doing its best Ridley Scott impression. This makes it derivative, sure, but that doesn't mean it's immediately bad. Underwater is a solid, mostly effective horror movie. We're plunged into the thick of things almost immediately. An underwater drilling crew gets thrown into disarray when a subaquatic earthquake destroys most of their facility. Cracking glass, busting airlocks, the whole nine yards. It's not long before people start to piece together the fact that it wasn't just tectonic activity causing them so much trouble. This is no disaster movie, if you catch my drift. Kristen Stewart leads the cast, doing her best Sigourney Weaver. Level-headed and solid as a rock, she does a majority of the heavy lifting in this role. Other characters are kinda flat, both in writing and delivery, and we're also treated to a past-due performance by TJ Miller doing TJ Miller things. If you liked him in Deadpool, you might find yourself rolling your eyes a little here. Can't win them all. Director William Eubank does a respectable job taking all sorts of parts from the previously mentioned Deep Space series and implementing them in the equally unexplored depths of the ocean. From direction choices to freaky phallic monsters to some surprisingly similar sound cues, you name it. The water is always used effectively, thank goodness. Could you imagine if they made a movie called Underwater and biffed the use of water? It's ever present, leaking and dripping and bursting through in murky torrents, ensuring that nobody can see too far ahead, keeping the tension high. If you don't mind a bit of big budget schlock, Underwater is a perfectly serviceable deep sea monster movie. Sledding in at number 3, we've got The Lodge. If you can trust a distributor to put out consistently engaging stuff, it's Neon. Between them and A24, there has been a veritable gold rush of excellent small to mid-budget horror, among other indie and art house goodies. The Lodge premiered at Sundance in 2019, but got released in February of 2020, so we'll count it for this list. Any fans of Goodnight Mommy will be thrilled by this next entry by its creators. This is a darkly atmospheric psychological horror that shakes you to your core. It's not going for cheap scares or trying to pay homage to all sorts of classic films. The Lodge just wants to make you as uncomfortable as possible for as long as possible. The odd, irresponsible bottleneck plot devices are easy to ignore once you let yourself get drawn into the weird web of gaslighting and cult activities. We're introduced to a man who wants a divorce after a long separation. He's found a new woman, Grace, who survived a mass suicide-committing cult. This prompts his current wife to commit suicide herself, scarring their two children. Following a period of grieving, the father convinces his kids to spend Christmas with his new wife at their remote cabin. This, of course, leads to plenty of hostility between the kids and their new stepmom. They are rude and indignant towards her, often outright ignoring her. This takes a toll on poor Grace, who finds herself in an unfamiliar situation full of proto-religious imagery with people who just don't like her. Things take a turn for the worse when Papa heads back to the city for work and inexplicably leaves the three musketeers in the lodge together. Stuff gets weird fast. Reality is questioned. Is there gaslighting going on, or is something truly sinister happening? What happened to the heater? Is purgatory real? All these questions compound and slowly build towards an insane ending. Creeping in at number two, we've got Come to Daddy. I don't want to say too much about this one. There's a twist, and everything spirals out of control from there. Maybe just go watch the trailer, see what you think. I guess what I will say is that it stars Elijah Wood sporting a ridiculous haircut. The plot concerns a rich, goofy musician who just so happens to be a recovering alcoholic. He's invited to his estranged father's lakefront estate for some long overdue catching up after all those years lost. Things start out pleasantly enough, but soon enough, Dad starts acting strange and violent. He's constantly making shady phone calls under the cover of darkness and begins to actively undermine attempts to connect with his kid. One thing leads to another, and some best kept secrets are indeed revealed. This all snowballs and becomes ridiculous very fast. I suppose I'll end off by saying that Daddy isn't who he says he is. Come to Daddy is funny and scary without sacrificing one for the sake of the other. It's a wicked screwball of a movie, and once it gets going, there's no stopping. Worth a watch for sure. And sneaking in at number one, we've got The Invisible Man. How could I leave out the breakout horror of early 2020? Blumhouse does it again, $100 million on a $9 million budget. Directed by Lee Whannell and starring Elizabeth Moss, this is a classic idea done very, very well. We follow a woman haunted after the death of her manipulative d*****head partner. Even though he's apparently dead and gone, strange things keep happening to her. She's passing out at odd times, and her friends are being attacked by invisible forces, making them assume that it's her doing the deed. Soon enough, she's framed for a violent crime and committed to a mental hospital. So what is happening? Is she going nuts, or is there an invisible man creeping around in the periphery? Well, considering how brand spankin' new this one is, I won't say much more. But seriously, this flick outperformed my expectations. The other Universal classic monster movies kind of flopped, right? I was expecting more of The Mummy, more of Dracula Untold, more of The Wolfman. But by keeping the budget tight and the outlook fresh, Whannell and Moss are able to elevate this one above its contemporaries. This sparkly new take on an older tale does wonders. The Invisible Man foregrounds the suffering of a woman at the hands of a manipulative abuser in a smart, non-exploitative way, and really uses the invisible aspect well to keep the tension high. Every scene is shot in such a way that makes you think that the ghostly man could be in the background at any given moment. It just works. Moss gives a great performance, and Whannell steers the ship clear of disaster towards pristine waters. This is one that's getting a lot of talk and attention right now, so you should probably go and see it if you want to be able to talk shop with the general public. Plus, now I want to be invisible so I can mess around with people that I've sworn revenge on. Watch your back, commenters. 2020's got a spicy outlook going forward, but these are 5 fearsome flicks to keep you satisfied until the next big thing hits. Also, go see VFW, I just couldn't fit it in on the list after talking about it in another video. So what do you think? Any 2020 horror flicks that I missed? What are you most looking forward to in the coming months? Make sure you let me know down in the comments. Speaking of comments, let's take a look at some of your more modern ones from top 5 SCPs that are absolute jokes. Coup de Grace says, let me guess, you guys couldn't be bothered to put the procrastination rock on this list because you couldn't be bothered. Yeah, I don't know. I figured I could leave it until next time. No sense doing it now if I can just get to it later. Phantom Ironhide says, I've been a joke all my life, yet no one seems to laugh. Not even the audience. I'll laugh for you, Phantom Ironhide. Does that make you feel better? Java Bee Palace says, Lucy, stick to the point. Little joke here and there. Keegan, jokes before the videos start, brings up a topic with more jokes, and ends with another joke. I don't know what to tell you, maybe cry more? Grace says, I have that peep, so you better stay the hell away from me and my family, you hear? That thing is an abomination and I want nothing to do with it. And Musical Melanie says, hello. Well, hello to you too. That's all the time we have for today. Before I try to take a bear cub away from its mom, make sure to give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe for more popcorn spilling pop culture. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. On 16 millimeters, which is always millimeters. Oof. Director William Eubank. We follow a woman haunted after the death. We want to be able to discuss.